Chupacabra is one of the best myths ever.
El Chupacabra.
Chupacabras.
Chupacabras.
Chupacabras. You've never heard of it?
It's a difficult creature to describe because nobody's ever actually seen it.
Chupacabras doesn't exist. It's a fairy tale.
The legend is that it's a very scary creature.
It has like these huge claws, these spines coming out of its back, these huge teeth, and it was very scary.
The adult weighs approximately 500 to 800 pounds. Bear-like, with retractable claws.
People would think of him like basically a vampire. I could kill people, but honestly, the only thing that he hurts is cabras, goats.
But our depiction is a much sweeter, friendlier Chupacabra.
It's okay, it won't hurt you.
Our Chupa kind of turns that mythology. Chupacabra in our movie is not horrific.
Chupa's not like that. He's very sweet and kind and cute.
Chupa. It's a baby Chupa, and babies are always cuter than adults.
When I first read the script, I thought it was very interesting, the twist that the story has, in which Chupa, the baby creature, is this very adorable animal.
It's basically a little puppy or a koala, sea lo que sea.
And he's not like thirsty for blood or anything like that. He's just a kind, loving creature.
You know, a misunderstood Chupacabra, which it's nice to take a fable and spin it on its ear a little bit and make it the kind of story that we're trying to tell.
I know Chupa's like this crazy mythical creature and Alex is just this kid, but they both feel very alone. They both feel like they need a friend and they can relate to each other. They understand each other.
When Alex finds Chupa, when they find each other, I do think there is that bonding of discovery.
You don't have to be alone anymore. I'm gonna take care of you.
Still, we're dealing with a mythical creature. Chupa, the baby, does have parents.
Up there!
That's where we realized we could play with it. We could keep Chupa very, very cute and adorable like a cub, but show the potential that the creature could have to be threatening and still tied to its mythology. You know, it's a kid's movie, but there's still that little bit of the mythical sense of a monster. When I think back to when the Chupacabras myth came out, it was very exciting to think that there could be a monster out there.
I feel like thinking about something that doesn't exist is like an adventure, like takes you to a new world and super fun.
You just want to believe in imagination and fantasy.
It's beautiful.
We still like to know that there are unknowns out there.
Chupa!
And a lot of what excited me about Chupa was being able to show a movie with a magical creature like those movies that I grew up with as a kid, but that was very specific to a Mexican mythology.